Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I have gave you redoing the parable of 10 virgins, Matthew 25. Then shall the royal kingdom of God be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps. Lamps are source of light. So that means those who have built up their faith by preaching gospel, they have a stronger light or more oil. And went forth to meet the bridegroom. Bridegroom is our father. And five of them were wise. The five of them were like the Samaritan woman at the well, who have overpowered all the five temptations of her heart or of her mind. Remember, the Bethlehem star is five-cornered, and that I have explained in another video why there were five corners. There are three against two, two against three. When three belong to ego, two belong to mind. So when your ego and your mind is under control, under the wisdom, are controlled by wisdom, then you are sealed to serve God. And those five are under control, and your house is at peace. So this is best explained through lecture, you know, but I hope many people will understand, and they are lucky one. And five of them were wise, and five were foolish. The foolish one were those who were clever people, who too understood the word of God, but they did not put into practice. They used it for psychic abuses. Remember some of these people, you know, they know the word of God, but they misuse it, and they turn stones into bread. The simple-minded people, by giving them sycophant or sugar-coated sermons, they lower them into their net, and they live lavishly. They live, and the poor people suffer. They live on widow's mite. They have no conscience. They are clever people. So these I have explained already. And so these five, you know, which are three of ego, ego of the flesh, ego of your physical fitness or some other skill, ego of the book knowledge, and the people in Jerusalem reading written Torah, old wine. This is the old wine, drunk with the old wine. So these three are of ego, these two are of mind. The mind is greed. When you are twice born, you know, try to be, make, cheat people and make money. Greed is the tempting power to you. Judah Iscariot fell victim to that one. While when you become wise men, then you have two choices: to become a ruler, that means take administrative force, become a minister or something, you know, where you rule the people. All right? And in Jesus we serve. Serve means that instead of ruling, we serve the people. We are humble. We are not lords. Pope became the victim of this one. He became the Lord over the people. To lord over people, he called Jesus a Lord also. So most of the Pope, they were once born, you know, but they got this clever psychic, you know, became so. So the Samaritan woman had overpowered the three of ego and two of mind. She was led by wisdom. She was sealed to serve God. Okay? So that is the five husbands, and they which she had overpowered. So those 10 virgins mean the five of them have overpowered all those five. The other five fall short of those. They did not, could not overpower them. They were victim of one or the other. So that's why their oil was less. This is the oil, you know, when you're overpowered, your faith in God is great. As the Samaritan woman at the well, it is with her faith in God that she got Jesus into deep, deep discussion, which even the laborers were surprised to hear. So that represents the knowledge of the, how much oil the Samaritan woman had. But the Jewish people, they hate Samaritans. They even today hate Samaritans. And there was a professor who done a big book, treatise, about 1,500-2,000 page book on John's Gospel. And during question time, I asked him, does he know Saint Fortina? That became Saint Fortina, you know, Samaritan woman at the well. No, he doesn't know. And he even still said she was a bad woman. And so they are brainwashed, you know. So we have to bring that Saint Fortina into light. God bless you. And let's carry on with the rest. So, then shall the royal kingdom of God be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. Remember that they are twice born people, both five virgins who were full of oil. They were twice born, sealed to serve God. The other were also twice born, because without twice born, you cannot know God. So the once born people, they had no lamp. Their light, lamp is without light. They have the wick, but no light. So this is only, this parable is concerned to the twice born people, clever, and those who are wise. So five are wise, five are clever. So, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And five of them were wise and five were foolish. Foolish means those clever, you know. They that were clever took their lamps and took no oil with them. They may think, you know, they can borrow it always, you know, they can understand from other people. Gospel is not received like that. You have to work yourself up. But the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight, there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom cometh. Go ye out to meet him. That means the God, when he comes, meet you, there's no time for him. You have to, you know, wait. You have to long for it. And he takes his own time, player. He knows when to meet you. In Jesus, we are the light. And in darkness, we can find our way. But without light, which we call SATT in Punjabi, you cannot find your way to God, our Father. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you, but for us and you, but you go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourself. Remember that, you know, gospel, you cannot give one person give to the other. You receive it from our Father. So you have to work yourself to get the gospel and the oil. Remember that when people have Eucharist, the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit, that is mocked the most. You cannot pour the Eucharist wine from one cup, that means one person, into another cup, the other person. That you can't do it, you know. Like Jesus could not give gospel to Peter unless his, our Father gave him. Gospel is received through the grace of our Father on individual basis, or solitary basis. Thus, faith in God or gospel cannot be transferred from one person to the next. So, to the next, but you yourself have to gain it by putting His word into practice. So you have to, you know, work yourself. You cannot make fool of the people that you can borrow it or you can learn at the last moment. Clever people listen to His word, and being psychic, they prefer the praises of men rather than to glorify our Father. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage. That means those who are clean-hearted, like Saint Fortina, Samaritan woman at the well, they get married to our Father. While the clever people, psychic, like the Messianic Jews, they are kept back, you know, they are clever. They are the clever virgins. And the door was shut. Such clever people first want to see what happens to those who believe in God before they themselves believe in God. So they while away the precious time, and get too old to listen to His word, but they repent afterwards. Afterwards came also the other virgin saying, Lord, Lord. So that's what they shall try, you know, that sycophant, that by calling Jesus a Lord and He will be pleased, you know. It is not so. Afterward came also the other virgin saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. That's why Jesus said, you know, people will call me Lord, Lord, but they will not do my Father's will. But He answered and said, Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. So in God, we do not work for reward in mind, but doing His will and leave it to our Father God Himself. It is by grace that He, the seventh husband, you remember the parable of marrying one husband after the other? The seventh husband is God, marries you, and with the blessing of Holy Spirit makes you His own spokesman, as the workers at Pentecost were made apostles, His own spokesman, according to His own pleasure. So all those are workers at the Pentecost. They were blessed with the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, and that made them the twin brethren of Christ Jesus. Remember, James the Just was already a twin brother because he was humble and righteous person. So in righteousness and in humbleness, he already attained the twinship of Jesus. He was not a physical twin. He was spiritual twin. Many people, they do not understand spiritual things. Even most of these people, priests you come across, they don't know what stones stand for. Stones stand for thick-headed, once-born people. So turning stones mean into bread means turning these thick-headed people, simpletons, devoted people, into your bread. They pay for your living, pay for your car, house, and everything. So turning bread, stones into bread. And our Father God bless you, and hope you understand this parable.